Ahoy there, I'm TinyPirate. Welcome back to Dawn of Man. And, oh, there's a wolf attack. What's going on? Oh. Well, that was over pretty quick. It looks like one of our doggies and people got to it. Never mind. So, yes, I'm looking here and feeling quite pleased with myself because things are going along, I think, quite well. Where are we? The game's on max speed. The housing's laid out quite nicely. I'm a little bit concerned about how I'm going to squeeze walls in. Actually, I think that's arguably going to be the hardest thing. Maybe I can fit a gate there and tear down this and just kind of snake all the way around. Something like this. But I'm not sure. I'm just going to be a bit conscious of not gumming up where wall's going to go. But we do have a little bit of tech to spend. So I was thinking I would get goat domestication. Bum, bum, bum. Just because I like to party. And I like to party with goats, maybe? I don't know. That sounds weird. I kind of feel like towards the storage areas would be good. I want to make sure there's enough room around them. But now I need to kind of hunt for, you know, hunt for goats. So, what are you, one of our dogs joining us? Or a dog out there joining us? I don't know. I'm not seeing the ibexes, bit of meat out there being gathered. No, it's not coming to me. So I'm just gonna have to keep an eye out. They shouldn't be too hard to find. And I definitely haven't seen any woolly mammoths in a while, so I think we've just advanced, unfortunately, beyond them, without the chance to hunt them, which I'm actually a little bit sad about. But life goes on. In the Mesolithic. I did get that right. Neolithic, what am I saying? How could I dare even presume that? So, we're going to get the stables up, which we've done, because we are highly organized today. And we just don't have anything to put in it. So, it's kind of a bit of a shame, really. We have linen going in, so at least we're getting the right kind of clothing. And I think I can tell them to stop that now. I think we'll be able to keep up just with the linen, and that means I can be producing a little bit more of the useful stuff that we need. So that is a ton of bows. I'm super, super pleased with how this is going, compared to the other game where everything just was a bit clunky, never quite worked brilliantly. This is excellent. I'm going to go on a little bit of an ibex hunt as well for the goats. Just give me a second there, chaps. Well, we have no time to hunt for ibex because some raiders have come in. Oh my gosh. Oh wow, that's quite a few, and they're right there. Ah, damn it. That really sucks. We do have a lot of bows, so I'm kind of hoping that... See, they're kind of grouping up interestingly. Actually, that's a lot of them. Why are they all... Okay, just smash them. Get the alpha strikes in. Come on, people, I need you here. I'm trying to be a bit careful with the controls. If I single click, if I double click, they're not necessarily any faster. Finish them. I think that's all of it. Well, we lost one person, which considering the size of that raider party is not too bad. Not too bad at all. So, they're all doing a little cheer there. Good on you, chaps. Get back out there and do me some more work because we have fields to harvest and food to gather. And I need to... Are we seeing enough? Do we need another mortar and pestle? Kind of thinking about it, you know. I think maybe one more would be a good idea. And I'm going to put it somewhere around the granaries. Yep, on top of the dead raiders. Sounds like a great idea. And meanwhile, yes, I will finally go. I will... Oh, ibex? You got an ibex for me? I don't really want to... Yeah, I don't really want to buy a goat for that much money. Oh, 50. High commission. No, you can get out of here, pal. I'll wait for someone with a low commission, and I'm going to go look for ibex to collect myself, thank you very much. And of course I found none. Found a couple of older ones miles away, but no children. We're just going to have to wait and be patient. If a trader turns up with one or two, I might just buy them. Now, and that actually reminds me that I've in the past made good money selling bows and stuff. Bows use dry skins, skins, those use one, and a stick. I don't know, maybe we'll look at these limits here. Do we have any limits on bows? Swords? No, I'm just going to put them up to infinitely available. Hopefully, Hopefully we'll make a surplus. We already seem to have a surplus, so we will be able to sell off a couple, maybe make a few dollars. And we do actually have some tech in, I've just noticed, so that's good news. Actually, what was that? Hang on. Were there any goats there? No, move on. So those are the sheep creatures that we don't have the skills to harvest. Unless I grab that. Do we have it now? Where are the rest of you? Come to me. Well, those are dead. And, oh, that was like a young one. Just the wrong time. Never mind. I'll get some more, I can promise. But apparently we won't be doing that today. Foiled by these creatures. I suspect you guys are mostly idle, so it could be time at least to throw down another residence. Oh, not a stables. Another residence, just to... Right, they're nice huts, aren't they? Just to give us the option in case more people come through. So, you guys, do that job. The rest of you, try and look busy. Aha, I have found them. Creatures I can capture. So, well, at least one of them. So, you do that. Someone go and hunt the ibex, just because the adult one. Grab the kid and take it back to our stables. It can be the very first of our minions. Still no other options out there, but a couple of people are heading out this way. I'm hoping that we'll be able to see our stocks grow, because animals are a very reliable form of farmed animals are a very reliable form of protein in this game, and that is always a good thing. Meanwhile, everything else here seems to be ticking along very well. Just keeping a little eye on our stocks. Why have we got slings? We must have picked them off the body of someone. We can sell those off. And bows are going completely bananas. So we got a hundred billion of them to sell off. Maybe not quite that many, but a few anyway. And I think we're going to throw down another residence, which I'm going to keep filling up this hill with. I've put down yet another storage site because I feel like these were definitely getting full. That one is empty, really. Where are we going to get the flint? I'm going to have to get the mining just so I can grab the flint mining. Where are you? And then the flint mines should last a little longer. Anywhere over the back here? Okay. Oh, well, there's one. That'll do for now. So, trader, come here. Give us your things. Give us a goat. What will you take these bows for? We're down to two goats, maybe. Get rid of these. I'm convinced those are spear. Get rid of a bone spear. A bunch of bones. We don't need that many. That is way more harpoons. Whoa, we can actually possibly afford that goat after all. That's way more harpoons than we ever possibly will need at this rate. Yeah, bam, let's do it. Bunch of goat time. Woohoo. Our goat population is soaring. Which means milk, and that helps our general health and well-being and nutrition and all that kind of stuff. And general happiness. I think that's going to be excellent. And other than that, we've got here flax is fine, barley, peas, and lentils. So that's a good mix of crops. Let me just remind myself, is flax a winter? I think flax and... So peas, barley, peas, and lentils makes me think we could probably throw in another barley crop. And I like barley just for the extra sort of straw it provides, which is actually something we're going to be a little bit short of. That's possibly a little bit too much work, but it's a good spring job for them to do. Whereas the barley and the peas and what have you, sorry, the peas and the flax and the lentils are the, whatever I said that we had, they are the summer winter jobs. So, yeah, stab those fields good. And I'm thinking about the wall and I'm planning that I'm pretty much going to have to come through here. So I'm going to tear these down. I might put them a little bit over here where we do have... What's going in there? Our mortar. But we do have a little bit more of our production site. So I don't want to put it right in front of the stables. That'd be a bit depressing for the poor old animals. We'll put two there. And maybe one there. And I think that would be plenty. Tear those up. And I do sort of plan a gate here. At least one gate... then we'll see going this way. These piles can all be moved as well. Which I might start doing just for my own peace of mind. I'm so impressed with how quick things are early in the game. It seems late game, and I think really the late game when I'm talking about it is the other series I'm running, where I'm still working on trying to get to 200 people. And that's having real issues, and I think it's because the towns are so spread out. So we're very close to the next tech level. I'm not sure, I'm hoping we can get through. Recycle these too. I don't know, we'll just put stones over here for now. Up on the top of the hill will do. There we go, just shove them there for now. So yeah, that should be okay. I'm feeling this. These are kind of parameters of the town. Sort of want to come along here, maybe fields, small fields will go along these, the edge of this cliff here. That should easily get us to a pretty large enclosure. I'm also conscious that I don't really need to enclose right now. Like, I think maybe the towers would be more useful than enclosing. I can actually put... Like, I know where raiders are coming from. It's over here. Over this side. I can put a tower up. Just rally people. The walls just kind of limit our ability to grow. I'm not convinced they're 100% useful at this stage. Look. Look here at what I've found. I've found woolly mammoths. And you know what that means? That means a woolly mammoth hunt. I've been wanting to do this for a little while. I am... You know what? I'm actually going to do this. I'm going to sort of... We're in the middle of harvesting, though. It's harvest season. Will the mammoths hang around? Oh, that one just died. Oh, go and grab that. Okay. Slow down. You're escaping, but we're going to help your extinction by summoning that many people. I think those all look like hunters. And telling them to go hunt. Let's have a look. Are they going to do it? These all look like hunters. So five of them. Let's do it. And they're not running. They're just walking, which is kind of annoying. I don't think I can make them move any faster. Ooh. Actually, we'll grab some of those too. But for now, where did they all go? Where are my people? What? Where are they? Oh, here they go. Oh, slow down. I want to get in closer. I want to go here for the screenshot, you know? Let's turn off the interface and turn off all the other things so I can watch this nice and closely. Come on, lady. Drop this big boy. Give him a bit of the old one, too. Let's sneak up on him a bit more. Well, here, isn't it? It's a lady-on-lady battle, just like what you get in certain locations with jelly, but no jelly involved here. Just armed combat to the death. We're sneaking. This is a really uninspiring camera angle, guys. Oh, wow. Okay, that's a little bit more exciting. Oh, well, that was pretty quick. And now we're just chopping up. You poor little mammoth. I hope I got a good screenshot out of that. That's all I can say. Control K, Control Shift U. Brings back my interface. And, well, we got a bit of tech knowledge from that. That's a good point. So a bunch of resources coming out. Hardened Survivor. I got an achievement. I wonder what that's for exactly. I don't really know. But I... Oh! Some of you people have no warm clothing. That's a shame for them. Oh, I actually do need to add in my straw. There we go. Tons of straw. So, unlock time. Palisade, gates, water, well digging. We'll do that. I don't know. I'm going to build it because I think everyone likes to see them. I just get annoyed by them. Slightly. I'm just bitter. What? Nope, that didn't fit. Let's try again. I was really hopeful there. Like, that's a bit of a shame. Alright, cool. That will kind of work there. And then let's see what we can do with... No, let's go this way. One in. And really the main place we need to worry about is towards the back where we keep seeing people attacking us. So let's smack in. No. Oh, God. Ah. Now, is it this? Oh, the outfitters in the way. Okay, outfitters, you're just going to have to move. It's always these little problems that bother me. And, you know, beguile me. You down to sort of here. I mean, these are massive walls. It's going to take them ages. So yeah, I do sometimes, as you've probably noticed, cut to when I'm no longer asking them to do these ridiculous jobs. And really the reason is that these take ages, and sometimes you don't want to overburden them with other jobs. So they're just going to sit there, and they're just going to, you know, slowly do these jobs while they go about gathering food and all the other jobs they have to do. Okay, we got the gate up. Nice. I think some of my people have no warm clothing. Well, that's probably because I tore down the outfitters. So it's time to put the outfitters over here with the storehouses and all that junk. I should now be able to get my final wall piece in. Yes. And then I can enclose across the front here. And it feels like it would be sensible. And there's a reason why I'm going to do gates like this, and I'm not going to tell you what it is. If you can figure out why I'm actually, there's a very good reason why I'm doing that. You can, if you can figure that out, good on you. You can comment below. If you can't figure it out, then trust me, it's a good reason. And it almost makes sense. Like in my other testy bits and bobs, it does. I don't know if that was quite correct there, but there we go. That'll be fine. Do I want a gatehouse here? Why not? In fact, I want a couple. There we go. I mean, if they just get that done, it's quite a reasonable enclosure. I haven't covered off the front yet, but I can definitely see myself staging outwards from there. And it's also time while we're here to add more workload to them by putting down yet another hut. Yeah, I like this little town. I like this little hill. It adds a bit of flavor to the whole situation. 32 bows, 32 people. Are they even carrying bows all the time, though? Not necessarily. I could sell some if I really had to. They seem to be doing their own sensible stuff here. We do have a ton of harpoons, though, so the traders are definitely going to pick up at least 10 to 15 of those. There's no way everyone's using all of them. And those walls are coming up. Beautiful. There will or should at least be one defensive structure there too. Kind of want to make this one here the high priority one. Some of my people have no warm clothing. Well, I know. I don't know what to say about that. We're trying our best. The skins outfit, maybe we'll put on like 3-4 skin outfits. Yeah, that should help. Meanwhile, wood and sticks. We're down to low on sticks. Could it be that we need more stick extraction? I'm just having a little hunt around. That's a lot of sticks. Let's put one there. Meanwhile, what exactly are you doing? Oh, you're gathering sticks. How many have you got? Does it show me? Oh, you can actually see their inventory slots. That's cool. So normally you like to go fishing, but you've gathered yourself some sticks, and now you're taking them. Are you going to do something else with them? You're going to put them somewhere. Gregor. Gregor. Oh, there you are. Where are you? Can I follow you? You're going to follow you. Okay, you're going to pick up grain. I'm kind of interested to see what their daily sort of workload is, what they're up to. So you're doing the grain smashing. Fantastic. Taking it to storage. Yeah, I kind of think I need to move the other, like another pistol, mortar pistol, closer to the grain storage, to our storage sites over here. Yep, see, there's another one doing that. That seems a bit slow and inefficient to me. Water gathering. Yeah, that's the next thing, the research we're picking up. Okay, so that's given us something to immediately do, which is to unlock the wells, prioritize this as well. And to put in a well, which can sit there. And we will tear that down once the next one goes up. But I don't want to waste it just... Well, I can tear that down right now. Yeah, it might actually provide a couple of stones for them. So it does. Well digging unlocked. And I think actually another well over here, because I can imagine it's useful sort of on a per house basis, right? So each house might find that handy. Okay, oh, what do we got over here? Anything to steal? No, actually. Sorry, where is our animals tab? So we have 9 goats. Yes, we're going to grab you. Any more ibex scissors? No, no more young ones, but 10 would be very handy. And the reindeer or what have you are coming through. Fish stabbing is going on. Yeah, everything's ticking along beautifully. Workload is too high. Well, you're just going to have to put up with that. That's in. Good, but these are so weak. Almost too weak, it feels to me. But I don't know. I mean, the game doesn't want to make it that easy. You don't want to just turtle up and just never have any stress. Okay, get out of here. So we've got raiders coming in from this side of the river this time, which is a little distressing. I just about accelerated through everything. And I've got 2, 4, 6 of my warriors all tucked away uselessly in these buildings. The rest of them are gathered here, which is a pretty good spot. Let's get over here, though. Come on, you guys. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Run, run, run. Get them while they're in the river. Yeah, that's right. Fill them with... Yes, that's what I like to see. And we got them all? I think we did. Oh, that's brilliant. Okay, so that teaches me that I need at least a defensive structure along here. There's a bit of an early warning. And I've put in for 3 to go in here. It's going to be a little bit busy work for them. But they're just going to have to put up with that. It is good to know that we can ambush them right in the river, which makes their day very, very miserable. And that's the kind of day that raiders should have. I mean, they should go build their own village. We did it. No reason they shouldn't do that themselves as well. So this lot's all coming along pretty well. I'm quite pleased. Population is pretty good. We do have another hut coming up, and I've set another forestry area over here because I kind of just want to clear all this out, to be perfectly frank. I'm sort of thinking, I'm going to put a stables here because we're already at maximum population. I'm sort of thinking of building the wall out a little bit, sort of through here, because it is flat land, and that is a little easy to build some of the larger buildings on. And if we do want to get into, service trees, so to speak, a miner, nice one, or a megalith, then I will just sort of plant an actual plantation of those somewhere, rather than just rely on what the wild ones are doing. Anyway, I think that's probably enough for today. We've made really good progress, and as you can see, wow, actually I can get flint. Oh, wonderful, I can finally, where are we, production, where's my flint mine? Somewhere. Oh, thank God, there's a flint mine. I can finally more reliably get flint again. But yes, I think we are doing pretty well. Not enough stable space, we know. That's why this building is very close to going up. And in the next episode, I think we should be able to see us advance into the Copper Age. And to sort of start... Whoa, we're already... Well, let's have a look. We can already unlock something else. Megalithism. Because I want to dig up this megalith, and we're going to put it right. You know what? We're going to put our spiritual men here. Right here. No, where is it? It's going to have to go right here. It's going to be the pilgrimage site. Bam. Going to come out of here and then look up the mountain to see where their dead travel. The spirits ascending the gateway to the heavens up this mountain. Anyway. Whoa. What happened there? Some poor dog died. Okay, poor thing. Let's chop it up. Anyway, these are all up. I shall catch you again soon. Until next time, I've been TinyPirate. Thanks for watching. Hope you'll like, subscribe, and if you super like my stuff, then maybe consider becoming a channel member. That would be awesome. Anyway, time for me to go. Good night.